Before we can understand how solar cells and solar modules work, we need to cover some fundamental concepts. One of these concepts is the structure of light. We are going to focus on the specific aspects of light structure that you will need to know in order to understand how to convert sunlight into electricity through photovoltaics. We will discuss the wave-particle duality of light and the solar spectrum. Light might be described either as an electromagnetic wave or as a flux of particles. This wave-particle duality is a quantum mechanical concept stating that every quantum object, including light, can be expressed as a wave or a particle, interchangeably. When we consider light as a wave, we consider it as a continuous entity. On the other hand, if we consider light as a flux of particles, we call those particles photons. You can think of photons as tiny little packets of light that flow out from any source. We are going to go through a couple of ways that we can use the properties of waves and particles to describe light. Firstly, let's consider the intensity of light. How would we describe intensity in terms of waves or particles? In both cases, how would we differentiate between high and low intensity light? For a wave, we use the amplitude. Higher intensity light would be modeled by a wave with a very high amplitude, while low intensity light would be modeled by a wave with a very low amplitude. So what about particles? Particles do not have amplitudes, so we cannot use that to model intensity of light. In terms of particles, we use photon flux, or the amount of photons per unit area flowing through. High intensity light would have a large flux of photons, while low intensity light would have a small flux of photons. Modeling intensity is one of the key differences between modeling light as a wave or as particles. In terms of particles, we are always thinking about counting individual pieces. Waves, on the other hand, are a single continuous entity. Another light attribute that is described differently when using a wave or a particle is the color of light. How can we differentiate between, for example, red and blue light using wave and particle properties? When considering light as a wave, we use the wavelength to differentiate between different colors of light. The wavelength is the distance between one peak of the wave to the next. The wavelength is equal to the speed of light divided by the frequency. So in principle, you could use either frequency or wavelength to describe a light wave. However, in photovoltaics, we typically use wavelength, which is designated by the Greek letter lambda. We typically use the unit of nanometers when talking about the wavelength of light. Red light has a wavelength around 700 nanometers, while blue light has a much shorter wavelength of around 420 nanometers. How can we describe different colors of light using particle properties? In terms of particles, different colors of light have different photon energies. That is to say, the amount of energy of each individual photon. This will often be designated by EPH, as shown here. When we talk about photon energy, we usually use the unit of electron volts, or EVs. An electron volt is the amount of kinetic energy gained by a single electron accelerating from rest through an electrical potential difference of 1 volt in vacuum. This is a very small energy quantity, corresponding to 1.6 times 10 to the minus 19 joules. That is 1.6 tenths of a billionth of a billionth of a joule. And 1 joule is 0.28 millionths of a kilowatt hour. However, this small unit is very useful when talking about small quantities of energy, like photon energy. Different colors of light consist of photons with different photon energies. For example, photons of red light each carry 1.8 electron volts of energy, whereas photons of blue light each carry 3 electron volts of energy. So if wavelength and photon energy can both describe the color of light, how are these two quantities related? This fundamental equation shows this relationship. C and H are both constants, where C is the speed of light and H is the Planck's constant. So the energy of one photon is Planck's constant times the speed of light divided by the wavelength. Photon energy is inversely proportional to the wavelength. Light with shorter wavelengths describe lights whose photons have a larger photon energy. Visible light is just one small part of the total electromagnetic spectrum. Here you can see that the spectrum ranges from gamma rays all the way up to long radio waves. However, for photovoltaic engineers, we are typically only concerned with the visible ultraviolet and infrared waves. That's because this is what the sun provides us with and is a spectrum of energy that we try to convert into electricity with photovoltaics. Here you can see the solar spectrum that is available just outside our atmosphere. We call this the extraterrestrial spectrum. On the x-axis, we have wavelength, and on the y-axis, the spectral irradiance. Spectral irradiance refers to the individual contribution of each wavelength to the total irradiance. The total irradiance is the area under the curve. You can see a large peak in the visible light spectrum, as is shown by the rainbow gradient. There is also significant energy in the infrared, as well as a small contribution in the ultraviolet regions. These three energy bands show this distribution, where the visible and infrared spectra make up equivalent contributions, and there is a very small contribution in the ultraviolet range. In total, the extraterrestrial irradiance is 1,367 watts per square meter. Note that this energy distribution provided by the sun is very close to the electromagnetic emission of a black body at a temperature of 5,778 kelvins. This is described by Planck's law. Remember that this is the extraterrestrial spectrum. When light travels through our atmosphere, some of it is absorbed and some of it is scattered. So if we put a solar panel at ground level, it will not receive this irradiance. We will see the effect of absorption of the atmosphere on the solar spectrum in the next video. Here we cover the wave-particle duality of light and how we can use the properties of particles and waves to describe light. We also went over the electromagnetic spectrum and specifically the extraterrestrial spectrum of light.